Okay, I just want to welcome everyone. I want to thank everyone for making the time and the effort to come and join us in this day. Today happens to be Mid-Autumn Festival as well in Asia, which makes it an extremely auspicious day today, which is kind of ironic. Because today we have South Africa and China on one platform. So today we cannot have any sound elevation or any banners, etc., because we stay into the holistic of what the garden is portraying and keeping it all natural. Yeah? So I'd like to, at the South African Health Qigong Association, we're based out in 133 Brewery Street, under the banner of International Qigong. Our idea is to make Qigong, Health Qigong, more accessible as an alternative free health system for every person, regardless of which community, social status quo they come from. It does not have the Qigong from the Chinese consulate. He works for the Cultural Affairs and Association, and we've also struggled to get the Chinese to acknowledge all our works in Cape Town. So forget the past, let's move forward, and now we're going to start a new journey together, and I hope that they will join us in this adventure and make it grow local and with our full support. Okay, so I'd like to, So I'd like to have the audience address the audience.
Thank you very much, Amanda. And by the way, I used to be a minister many years ago, before 2014. I'm now the Deputy Speaker of the National Assembly, and I'm absolutely glad. This man here is my doctor. Has been not only me, for many other MPs, but we are glad to join you. But this form of exercise is just what we need. Not only because of the stressfulness of the job, but also in the communities that we come from. Doing something like this, it feels great that I can do it with grandparents, with parents, with children. It seems absolutely exciting. And I felt I should come because I know there are many people, and I've read about it, and it's been my desire as well to get into it, given my own personal need. As I age, I need to remain fit, remain strong, and to be able to do all those things that people want to do, whatever they are doing. So I'm glad to be here. And and from the embassy, thank you very much. We hope together we can continue to support initiatives like this and let them spread wherever they are free. We will invite you to come and members of their families who stay there. It does look absolutely attractive. I've seen it from a variety of places. There are other things that I do that relates to health that have learned from this exercise. So I noticed the exercises that we're doing are quite similar, and in fact, the person who learned and improved their health does say that this sort of practices. But thank you very much. It's a great early morning exercise, I guess, whatever time of the day. But thank you very much, Amanda, for inviting me.
Thank you for coming. Incorporate the simplified kind of Qigong techniques and the healing techniques. bring physical, mental, and spiritual well-being to people. That's why when Dr. Lan and Lisa come to our concert about the festival and tell me about their story, they are actually Mauritius Chinese.
Yeah.
And they learn their Qigong in Mauritius Chinese culture. They moved to Cape Town and become a Capetonian about 50 years ago. They start from scratch. They start teaching Tai Chi, Qigong, and the Chinese martial arts, not only in their studio in the CBD area, but also in the township, and bring these traditional Chinese sports and culture to benefit to the underprivileged community. I'm greatly touched and moved by their endeavor and also their aspiration. So when they asked me to introduce this event, I won't hesitate to render our support. As you know, China and South Africa established diplomatic relations about 20 years ago. Throughout the 20 years, our relationship with our government has gone from strength to strength. But no matter how strong our relationship between our government, we always find our roots deeply and our foundation in the friendship between our people and our mutual understanding between our people. So I think through health Tai Chi and also events like today, it provides a very good platform for bringing our South African people and Chinese people together, and also to appreciate and to benefit from the traditional Chinese civilization. All in all, I think Qigong originated in China about 5,000 years ago, but it belongs to the world. I wish this event a great success, and I wish all of you great health. Thank you.
Okay. I'm gonna take some photos as well.
I think I could see better from this view now.
Yeah, there we go.
Out of the sun.
Yeah.
Thank you.
this.
There we go. There we go.
Someone's going to be watching this.
It's going to be me. Because I have to edit everything.
What happened to Ruby? Ruby.
We've had a really outstanding experience here. The energy was phenomenal. It literally knocked me off my feet for a while, but I've come back fighting and feeling strong and good.
I came with fibromyalgia flare up, which was very painful. I wasn't sleeping, and at first it was very hectic and the pain got worse, and then the health Qigong day really cured me. The pain is gone, I'm sleeping like a log, and the teacher was phenomenal.
Thank you so much.
It's so good for me. My body has loved it. I know what it feels for me. It's just, it does something for me. I don't have the signs. I don't know the signs. I don't know the terminology.
Qigong is beneficial for your coordination, especially for martial arts and athletic sports. Plus, it helps you with your healing. So, any damage you may have, it can assist you or prevent you from having these damages. I've been doing Tai Chi and Qigong for about 20 years, and this has opened some new doors. And after two major operations, I found that Qigong and Tai Chi combined are wonderful to get one's health back to normal. And if it wasn't for that, I wouldn't be here. So I'll be back for more. Thank you.
I found it very satisfying, very accessible, and yet quite profound. I'm looking forward to continuing the practice. I already feel some great benefits physically and mentally. And I think it's very high value what we've just learned.
Qigong is a way of life for me. Been a part of Qigong and in my life in a way.
Very minimal exposure to Qigong until now. I'm very, very pleased and very happy. I found it extremely challenging at points, but really fulfilling. Definitely a practice I'd like to keep up.
I started doing Qigong here 6 months ago. When I came here, in this morning, three times a week. It's unbelievable. I can do this, which the doctor and the specialist said I would never do without a major operation. So I'm really thrilled.
I should pursue health Qigong and get into it, and it's also been very helpful to me in helping me along my martial arts journey.
A year and a half later, I'm off my blood pressure, my hypertension's gone away, full mobility in all my limbs, hands, legs. I've lost 20 kilograms. And I think the most important thing is learning control of oneself.
I feel like I'm healing from an operation, and I feel a lot of internal stimulation.